If you need a pocket oscilloscope for your electronics projects, check out the Mini Oscilloscope DS211. My buddies over at Banggood sent me this oscilloscope and I thought I'd share my experience. The bandwidth on this unit is rated to 200,000 Hz, has a 1 million sampling rate, it's a single channel input and a single channel output, and it works off its own battery, which lasts about 3 hours. The maximum rating is up to 40 volts, but I'm using this for logic levels, so I'm not running anything over about 5. The kit comes with, of course, an oscilloscope, an instruction manual, and probes and color rings for your probes. The connectors for the oscilloscope and the probe are special. The probe, of course, has a standard hook end, but can be removed for a probing tool. On-off is on one side, and the connections for your input, output, and USB charging are on the other. Let's take a look at the user interface. You have a menu along the left-hand side and some settings along the top and the bottom. We can cycle through the wire range by clicking the left or the right arrow buttons, and we can cycle through the different menu options by the up or down button. If you press the menu, you can access things like the wire range, probe attenuation, and a few other settings. The probe attenuation can be set from 0 to a 10x multiplier. Next, let's take a look at the time base. Just simply hit the down button to get to the XN, and hit the menu to get to things like time base, sampling rate, and a few other settings. We can change this dynamically and watch our scale update as we change the frequency of our input signal. Next, let's take a look at the sync mode. You can measure on a rising edge, falling edge, do an auto fit, and a few other nice settings. I keep mine on auto. The measure setting allows you to monitor things like frequency, duty cycle, volt RMS, volt average, peak to peak, max and min. You can also save a bitmap, data file, CSV file, SVG file, and a few others. The unit also has a built-in function generator, so you can create sine waves, square waves, triangle waves, sawtooth waves. We'll see a little bit more in a minute. At the very bottom is a calibration mode, so you can restore your settings or do an auto-calibrate. Let's take a look at the measurement quality. I'm using a TNC 3.2 to generate a square wave, and right now we're going to crank up the frequency to 200,000, the maximum for this unit. The waveform is not real square, as seen on my other oscilloscope, which is a simple USB desktop-based unit. But as we crank our frequency down, we can see how the waveform cleans up a little bit. One anomaly that I've seen is the measuring of the duty cycle. Below about 70 or 80% duty cycle, it seems to track fairly well. Anything above that, the unit just doesn't seem to work very well. Watch as I adjust the duty cycle from 0 to 100. Let's take a look at the output waveform. I could go from square, sine, triangular wave, and sawtooth. You have complete control over the frequency, and for square waves, you can even control the duty cycle. If you're looking for a simple, low-cost, pocket-sized oscilloscope, check out the DS211. The waveforms aren't perfect at high frequencies, and it does struggle with high duty cycles, but for $80, it's good for quick checks. Thanks for watching.